everything is connected and affected, really.
One, two, oops.
Oh, another!
Fragile X syndrome is common. It's not only the most common identifiable inherited cause of intellectual disability, it's also the most common identifiable inherited cause of autism spectrum conditions. It affects as many as 1 in 3,000 to 1 in 4,000 individuals in its full mutation state, but it's far more common again in people who carry the premutation. The most common physical feature of Fragile X syndrome is just how normal and ordinary an individual appears. This is important because people, including professionals, often mistakenly believe that if you have a genetic cause for your disabilities, then you will look different. There are some subtle aspects. The head can be slightly largish and longish, with protruding ears, which often flush with high levels of anxiety or emotion. There might be a high arched palate, which can affect speech and language, and a longish flattened nasal bridge. The chin can be quite protruding, and usually there's quite widespread lax ligaments, hypermobile joints, flat feet, and occasionally some eye and hearing problems, and perhaps even some heart murmurs.
He has a low mobility, he has low muscle tone, double jointedness, you know, that affects the way he walks, you know.
There's a range of common behaviours and developmental aspects associated with having Fragile X syndrome. Intellectual functioning is usually in what we call the mild to moderate intellectual disability range. That's equivalent to an IQ of about 35 to 70.
His communication skills, social skills are affected. His writing, his memory, language skills, everything is connected and affected, really.
Speech and language can also be very characteristic. It can have a humorous or jocular characteristic to it. It can be quite repetitious, and it can have up and down swings of pitch. However, the communication skills are good. There's usually very high anxiety levels, which can often mediate the so-called challenging behaviours. In Fragile X syndrome, there are also often difficulties with concentration span, attentional skills, being restless, and also being very fidgety and impulsive and easily distracted. And if these features are marked, they may qualify the individual for having a diagnosis of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or ADHD. Also, individuals, and this is very true of Fragile X syndrome, have multiple marked sensory sensitivities.
It's a different world for him to understand, and it's very challenging for us to understand what he sees, what he feels.
If we go to somewhere where it's new, God forbid if it's dark, I mean, it's not so much now, but when we're younger.
If it's loud.
If it's loud, dark, new, crowded.
Smelly.
Yeah, we'd be outside for ages.
There's no doubt that individuals with Fragile X have raised rates of autism spectrum disorders. So whereas in the general population, it's only about 2% who have an autism spectrum disorder, in Fragile X syndrome, it may be as high as 20 to 30%. However, it's usually the paradoxical juxtaposition of a friendly and sociable, albeit shy and socially anxious personality in the presence of certain autistic-like features.
Once he gets used to the people, once he overcomes anxiety and the pressure of talking, two-way talking, he's fine with people.
He's beautiful hair, pink ears, pink.
He would kind of hide behind you first, and then he'd make sure he's with you, and bit by bit he'd come
and
out.
And he says embarrassing things.
Yeah.
Well, they're fine if they know them. If they're within their circle or the family circle or whatever it is, or they're with me when I meet a stranger, they're fine. On their own, they're not as good with strangers. Well, Jason, I can't say that about Jason, because he'll talk to anybody.
I love being around with friends and chatting to them all and chatting to customers and things, you know.
There's a lot of confusion about how Fragile X syndrome and autism relate to each other. Fragile X syndrome describes the cause of the challenges. In technical language, what we call an etiological label, that is the cause, and there may be a range of possible consequences, one of which is autism spectrum disorder.
It's a bit like autism, but he's not autistic. Yeah, I do say that. Yeah, it's a bit like autism, but he's not autistic. Yeah. He's very personable. He gets along with people. He likes to be around people.
Yeah.
There are quite substantial gender differences in Fragile X syndrome. So for males, who are usually full mutation individuals, the intellectual level will often be lower than females. there may be more marked hyperactivity and inattentiveness and more pronounced autistic features. In females, it's often more subtle.
It's a very hidden, you know, a very subtle issue, but it's massive for them and it's a massive social barrier. And, you know, it's a massive worry for them in the future.
There's enormous variety and range in how individuals with Fragile X syndrome can present. This depends in part of the level of intellectual functioning, so that those with more severe developmental disabilities may be more prone to challenging behaviours. It's as if actions speak louder than words for that group, particularly if their verbal language isn't that well developed. And that can lead to quite marked frustration, which comes out as behaviour, which is problematic for both the individual and others.
If they don't understand him, he will spit, throw things, cups of tea are often being thrown. And yeah, I've had my fair share of those as well. I've not always got it right.
For more able individuals, there may be anxiety states, there may be mood difficulties, and often it's the emotional trauma of being aware that you have developmental challenges, yet having extreme difficulty in overcoming them.
Howard had a real character, and unlike Ian and Susan, he let people know what he wanted. He let people know what he liked. And I suppose his form of challenging behaviour, if he wasn't understood, was to become quite introverted and start to shake his head and display it in those sort of ways.
It's very unpredictable, so you could have good few weeks and months of, you know, really good behaviour, and then things can change.
Yeah. All of them have got qualities that are far better than me, far better than me. And Howard, his way with people, he just got so many people who adored him like I did. Yeah, love him.
Do you mind me making that? I'm proud of it. Lizzie likes it, don't you?